Islam. Rise, 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 rise of Islam. Rise. We are stronger together, united as one Ummah. Rise, 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 rise of Islam.
Refusing to pay zakat. All around Arabia except for Medina, Mecca, and Taif, Shaitan was trying to weaken the new Muslims' iman or belief in many different ways. The five pillars of Islam are extremely important for all Muslims, but the evil made the new Muslims not want to pay their zakat. This was very dangerous because if Muslims do not follow the pillars of Islam, that would weaken our iman. And if Muslims have different definitions of iman, that would break the unity of the Muslim Ummah. In that situation, some of the good Muslims were scared to do anything and thought that it wasn't a big deal because they were still following the other pillars of Islam. But Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was very strict about following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's law and order, because he did not want anyone to change the real Islam. This made some of the new Muslim tribes really mad. So they decided they would attack Medina. All of this was happening when the Muslim army was still in the Arab-Roman border trying to stop the big Roman army from destroying the Muslims. Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu knew that there were only a few Muslims left to protect Medina, the center of Islam at that time. But in that difficult situation, Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu had strong faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and did not give up. To protect the city, the very smart Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu told some of the people to guard the Prophet's mosque. He also gave Zubair, Talha, Abdullah bin Masud, and Ali radiallahu anhu the most important job: to guard the city of Medina and to keep an eye on the enemies. When the enemy was coming, right away, Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu himself left Medina with some Muslims to stop them. But the bad people used drums and other loud sounds that scared the Muslims' camels. Then, the second time, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Muslims were able to stop the bad people. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's miracle, Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu saved Medina even though the Muslim army wasn't there. Around the same time, the Muslims got another good news. Usama radiallahu anhu's army returned from Syria after winning the battle that stopped the big Roman army from attacking the main center of Islam. Everyone was so surprised when they heard the news. In the battle, they won a lot of valuable items which made the Muslim army extremely strong. After this big success, smaller tribes who were planning to attack Medina because of the zakat situation got scared. They realized that even if the Prophet was no longer alive, the Muslims were still very strong and powerful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings. When the problem of Rome was solved, Caliph Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu wanted to establish peace agreements with their neighbors all around Arabia again. At that time, peace agreements were very important to do business. People would trade with many different tribes from the north to the south and east to the west. During those times, they used very specific paths called trade routes. If a tribe did not like another tribe, they could steal and they would not be able to do their business safely. So, the peace agreements were a promise to help each other as friends and to protect them from any trouble. During the Prophet's lifetime, many tribes made peace agreements with the Muslims. But after Prophet Muhammad ﷺ's death, they thought all the peace agreements were over. In their minds, they didn't have a peace agreement with the new Caliph of Islam. So, they also thought the Muslims were not powerful anymore to help their small tribes. That's why many tribes broke off their peace agreements after the Prophet passed away. To solve this situation, Caliph Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu gathered strong Muslims from Mecca, Medina, and Taif and made a total of 11 army groups. He sent each of the different groups to different tribes all over Arabia to establish peace agreements again and to stop the fake Muslims who were confusing and breaking the unity of the Muslim Ummah. For this mission, Caliph Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu chose Khalid bin Walid as his commander-in-chief. Some of the other top generals were Hudayfa, Shurabil, Arfaja, Tariq, Umar bin al-As, Khalid bin Sa'id, and Ikrama radhiyallahu anhu, who was the bad Abu Jahl's son. All of these Muslim generals left Medina and went to different directions to bring back the peace in Arabia. It was around 3 months after Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's death, in the month of Jumad al-Thani of the 11th Hijri. Caliph Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu sent the same message to all the tribes. Each of the generals explained the Caliph's message to the tribes that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away because he was a human just like us, and he was the last prophet, the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He only came to this earth to show us the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He came to bring justice and peace in this world. He came to give us the last holy book, the Quran, and showed us how to follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's law and order. And when his mission in this life was over, that's when he had to go away. But the Quran, the laws of Islam, did not change, and it will forever stay the same.